Hello, everyone. On a cold, dry February 11th night, the Zwicky transit facility at Palomar Observatory near San Diego, California, discovered a strange flash of light in the sky. Light has been traveling towards us for more than 8.5 billion years. Yes, more than half of the universe's lifetime. The telescope sent a warning about this unusual flash of light right after the discovery. To witness this rare phenomenon, astronomers set in motion several telescopes around the world. Then telescopes from around the world, including the Hubble Space Telescope and the NICER X-ray instrument aboard the International Space Station, observed this unusual flare at various wavelengths. After two more nights of work, the astronomers reported the source to the ephemeral name server, and the system gave it a cool, formal name, AT2022CMC. When astronomers observed and analyzed this source across the entire electromagnetic spectrum, they realized they were witnessing an extremely rare cosmic event. This strange flash of light was captured at the Zwicky Transit Facility. It was formed by a star-eating black hole in the far corner of the universe. This made it visible to our telescopes as the jet of stellar remnants exploded directly towards Earth. But how did astronomers learn it was a star-eating black hole? What happened a few minutes after the black hole destroyed the star? Finally, and most importantly, why was this discovery so important in astronomy? Let's explore the answers to these questions together. When you look at the stars at night, you may have noticed how calm the sky is. But appearances can be deceiving because space is not a quiet place at all. It is full of chaos and explosions. Stars die. Meteorites collide, and one of the unlucky stars stuck in my own state becomes prey to the hungry black hole. These acts of violence in the cold darkness of deep space generate powerful bursts of light, and astronomers can track these fluctuations of light to theorize about what's causing it. Also known as the tidal distortion flare, this event happens when the aforementioned unlucky star gets spaghettified when it gets close enough to the black hole, being separated by the tidal force of the cosmic giant. This is similar to the moon's magnetic field pulling the oceans on Earth, but with a much more power. Pieces of the star stretched out like spaghetti by the black hole are captured by a rapidly spinning disk around the black hole. Pulled by strong gravity, matter falls toward the central black hole while being fed by surrounding gas and dust. However, instead of falling into the black hole, a small fraction of the particles accelerate to nearly the speed of light and are scattered in two narrow beams along the black hole's spin axis. Such dynamic events open an unprecedented window into studying how a supermassive black hole can swallow any object. That's why astronomers are constantly looking for such events in the sky. The Zwicky Transient Facility is currently one of the most comprehensive temporary research facilities to study this phenomenon. In fact, modern astronomical studies discover this type of stellar spaghettization roughly once or twice a month. However, only three of them have been seen producing powerful jets before, most recently in 2011. When the AT2022CMC was discovered, astronomers first studied the source in the electromagnetic spectrum. This event was extremely bright, especially at X-ray wavelengths. The X-ray emission was radiating more energy in 1 second than the sun did in 10 million years. X-rays were also highly variable, varying in brightness on timescales as short as 15 minutes. In particular, it also had strong emission at radio and millimeter wavelengths and became brighter over time. In astronomy, the smaller the size, the brighter the object. About 4 days after discovery, the astronomers recorded a dramatic red color rise followed by decay. The color then slowed down and became more blue. The rapid evolution of this extraordinary luminosity across the entire electromagnetic spectrum on a timescale of several days made the AT2022 CEEMC extremely unusual. The light produced by the AATT2022 CEMLC began its journey when the universe was about a third of its current age. About 8.5 billion years ago, astronomers discover about 100 energetic transients each night, but since none of them have such unique properties, they continued their search, wanting to know what caused this bright flash of light. The event began when an unfortunate star approached the supermassive black hole in an almost parabolic orbit and disintegrated in a stream of gaseous debris. About half of the mass remained around the black hole, producing powerful shocks at its self-crossing point. The resulting gas then circulated around the black hole to form an accretion disk, and its rapid spin produced a pair of relativistic jets. The event occurred during a redshift of 1.19, or about 8 billion light years away. This makes the A2022 KEMIC the most distant jet tidal disturbance event discovered to date. So bright that astronomers witnessed a sun-like star be destroyed by a black hole a million times its mass. Researchers believe the object is at the center of a galaxy not yet visible because light from the AET2022 CEMSC is eclipsing the galaxy. But future space observations with the Hubble or James Webb Space Telescopes may reveal this shadowed galaxy when it eventually disappears after the transient event. We last saw such an event more than 10 years ago, but were unable to observe it. The black hole in such action was visible for the first time at optical wavelengths in the night sky. This cosmic event could be a new way to detect jet-firing disks across the vastness of space, allowing us to more deeply study these rare events and the black holes that trigger them. Daniel Purley, an astronomer and another co-author from Liverpool John Moores University in England, so far, the few known jet DDs have been initially detected using high-energy gamma ray and X-ray telescopes. But this was the first to be discovered during an optical survey, he added. That's all from us for now. What do you think about this issue? Do not forget to share your ideas with us in the comments section. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. See you soon.